Documents received by a former Philippine congressman allegedly point to an election official as having been bribed by a South Korean poll automation provider. The Philippine elections chief warns of a legal battle if the documents are used to implicate him. Sherry Ann Torres reports.
Former Caloocan Congressman Edgar Erice calls this parcel Bahamas Files, which he claims he received from an unknown sender. The parcel, which came from Bahamas in West Atlantic Ocean, contains the list of a Comelec official and his wife's supposed 14 bank accounts amounting to $15 million or some 877 billion pesos. It also includes details of the said official's reported four properties in Singapore, Hong Kong, U.S., and Makati City.
Nakalagay po doon na isang Comelec official ang nakatanggap ng milyong dolyar mula sa South Korea, allegedly from Miru. Binigay ko na po kay Chairman Garcia yung dokumento na yon, dapat po investigahan niya sapagkat nakakatakot po kung ang isang Comelec official ay tumatanggap ng salapi sa kakontrata ni Miru.
Erice did not name the election official he was alluding to during interviews, but in his letter to Garcia, Erice directly tells the elections chief to comment about his bank history. Erice has also sent a letter to Senator Risa Ontiveros, House Speaker Martin Romualdez, and the Office of the President asking to investigate Garcia's supposed bank transactions. Erice says he will ask the Supreme Court to cite Garcia in contempt.
Kung gusto niyo magkita-kita tayo sa Supreme Court, magpapile naman ako ng isang petition to cite Chairman Garcia in contempt of court. Bakit? Kasi pronouncement niya, sinasabi niya na pagkat disqualify o ninalify yung kontrata ng Miru, Comelec at Miru, sinasabi niya na magre-revert tayo sa manual election.
Garcia, meanwhile, questions the absence of the bank's official logo or letterhead enumerated in the Bahamas files. He believes the same font used in the Bahamas files proves that only one person produced the paper. The poll chief says Erice's submission of what he calls a white paper reveals who can be charged about those damaging accusations. Hours after Erice forwarded the files, Garcia shows Land Bank of the Philippines certification stating the identified account number as non-existent. This, he says, is proof that Erice and others who will be dragged into Bahamas false issue can be charged for falsifying a document.
Isa pa lang ito. So, alam nyo, kung gano'ng kadami ang bank accounts, gano'ng kadami ang falsification. Ngayon, yung lahat ng banko ngayon ay sinulatan ko rin ng ganito. Nangihingi ako sa kanila ng certification din. Makatulad dito.
Erice dares Garcia to just bring on the cases. Meanwhile, news about Erice's threat to file graft charges against Comelec officials before the Office of the Ombudsman has already reached Garcia, who has this to say.
Huwag po siya mag-alala dahil sasagutin naman namin po. Ang medyo kabahan siya ay yung kasong ipapile ng Comelec o ipapile ko kapag napatunayan kong fake lahat ng mga accounts na ito.
The Comelec is now being assisted by the Department of Justice in examining the Bahamas files. A check at the parcel's tracking number reportedly states that Bahamas files actually originated from the Philippines and upon reaching Bahamas was sent back to the Philippines on July 1st. Sherry Ann Torres, ABS-CBN News.